What's going on, everybody? Look at the Big League Sports Card today. Hope you guys are having a nice evening. It's kind of funny. So I was going through an old 86 set that I put together back in probably 87, Topps Baseball. And because I was going to pull some cards out to try to do a bulk submission on some modern stuff, not ultra modern, but maybe doing another modern PSA order. And it's done. It was like Thursday, man. You missed out. You totally botched that live broadcast last week. So why not just do this? It's not a box break, right? So it's going through a set, but I'm kind of show you. So this is literally the hand collated set that I put together like 1987. So gosh, what is that? 35 years ago? I don't know what that is. Something about the math here. So anyway, I got through about, I don't know, maybe 40 or 50 cards, and I stopped. I'm like, man, let's get this. Let's put this on the channel. I think some people get a kick out of it. I mean, not everybody, but anyway. So I'm really pleased. I think this is really the second time I maybe got this set out in those 30-something years. Probably the third time. But just want to show you some of the conditions of the card. So if you know 86 Topps, it's like 85 about Topps football. It's just brutally tough set. But like the Yankee sets, I mean, everything is black on the top right, so no matter what. But so I'm looking here at the Phil Negro, so obviously don't like anything else centering corners, but really the top border is the killer with this set. They chip, flake, it's brutal. But they're robbing you out. So as you can see here, guys, I'm pulling out some pretty pretty decent cards. Obviously not all of them like this. It's like I said, the first 80 cards is I pulled out three, right? The All-Star set is all white border, but it's just tough to find one that's centered. So right now I really got three cards I'll look at. I was probably being maybe, I don't know, I probably should have been a little bit more loose on this first round, but I was just taking my time, like, I got, don't really have anything else pending right now. But anyway, so I'm just gonna grab the next set of cards or stack of cards here and go through them with you guys and kind of show you what I'm looking for, and also maybe get you guys take. So I don't know, I thought it'd be kind of cool. Throwback Thursday, obviously. So 86 Topps, not a, like I said, not a wax break, but it's a hand put together set. But just kind of show you know what I'm looking for. So obviously this is a card that's obviously off-centered left to right and badly top to bottom. So this is an example of a lot of cards that you'd get. And I'm thinking back of so many years ago, I probably broke probably 10 to 15 boxes of this stuff. I think I was able to put together two full sets out of all of it. So there's boxes and boxes of just cards in there. A bunch of them are wax cards, which just have all the wax crap and gum cards that have the gum on the back. So it's tough, right? And there's one that's pretty well centered. That's a little bit bigger on top. But as you can see, guys, the color on these is outstanding. Look at the gloss on here. Like I said, this is probably the third time I've had them out at all. This may be the second, I think, maybe the last time I looked at the other set I put together, because it wasn't nearly as good. I'm kind of surprised, actually, I'm very surprised myself of how good this set looks. So like I said, we're just going through them here, seeing what looks good. And a lot of times, like I say, like a guy like his, like Al Bunbury, it's a little off center left to right, but it was perfectly centered. I'd pull it to the side because there's people that are trying to put this set together in the PSA 10, right? And Al Bunbury may be that last card they have. Like I said, there's a market for that stuff. So anyway, we keep going. It's down the hill, actually. Yeah, maybe a little bit better left to right. But top to bottom, that one's looks really good. But as you can see what I'm talking about, guys, the tops of these cards are outstanding. Gary Matthews. And it's pretty cool too to see like a lot of the players and Sabrehagen, he was a solid pitcher for the Royals there. That was not too bad. Just a tad off left to right. I mean, that one actually has a shot at coming back like a nine or something, but I should probably put kind of a stack over there of at least notable players. Jeffrey Lehner, man, this is a, I'm not sure if he was as mean as he looked, but the dude never smiled. Ever. He always had this kind of grimace, like, you know, like I said, I don't know if it was a tough guy image or this, that it was. You guys remember this guy, Pascual Perez? Pretty crazy dude. If you've never seen him, so I've seen him do it live before. One, he threw Eva's pitches, and two, he would try to pick guys off by throwing them in between his legs, looking underneath. I've seen him do it live against the Astros. So back in the day when the Expos were in the National League, and obviously the Astros in the National League West. But YouTube this guy if you don't know Pascual Perez. Pretty neat guy. Like, this is an example that was very typical, right? Just totally miscut. Just bad, right? Little like circles and weird things happening here. And Nicky, here's Mark Langston. Actually, that one looks maybe a tad off top to bottom. But not by much, though. Langston was a solid pitcher. Jay Johnstone, so obviously you guys remember him from a lot of TV stuff. Not the Bob Gibson, but. Don't know what that was. Benny Walling. Solid player for a long time for the Astros. It's kind of when he didn't have his mustache. He really had a pretty thick mustache most of his career there. Bill Russell. He always reminded me of Clint Eastwood in this card. Manny Camacho, some pretty nasty specs there. I think that may be the battery. Hang on, I better check this here real quick, guys. I don't think I plugged the laptop in. Nope, it is. Hang on, let me see if I can get this real quick. I don't have to stop it. Mad Dash. Can you get it in time? Or will he blow it? He will get in time. Wow, that was crazy. I'm not gonna find a place to put this stuff. It's kind of hanging there. I think we're all right. Are we still going? Hope so. This is still going. All right. That was insulting like a time. Sorry about that, guys. But using the software, and I forgot to plug in everything. All right, back to it. There's Keith Hernandez. And I think I need to move this guy, too, here. Sorry, I may get a little bit more glare on my face, but better action of the cards. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. So you guys can see that. That one's pretty well centered. Bob Baylor. It's got a little something going on right there. Like I said, he was wax packs, glue, gum, residue. So many things could happen with him. That Joe Price actually looks really clean. Like I said, I have no idea who Joe Price is, but look at that card, guys. That thing is tight, man. Top, bottom, left, right. I'm sort of going to put that up there. Marvell Wynn. Now, like I said, there's certain players you're looking for. Even the checklist, guys. You can get this thing to grab a PSA 10. People want that. Back when they had checklists. You guys remember that? Terry Pendleton? A little bit off. Like I said, there's a couple cards that you would love to have hit. I'm not going to jinx it, though. That Goose Gossage actually looks pretty solid, too. Goose is pretty intimidating, dude. Big dude. Big mustache, right? Always had the looks on. Or sunglasses. There's La Russa there when he coached, when he managed the White Sox. That one looks really good, too. Jeff Calhoun. He never really materialized anything for the Astros. He's supposed to be kind of up and coming. But I don't know. I think you come up that early and you're on a staff with Nolan Ryan and Mike Scott and Bob Knepper and Jim DeShays. And man, they pretty solid rotation. It was tough. There's Eck at the Cubs. I was off left to right. Glenn and Mother Hubbard, they used to call him. Rafael Santana. Sid Bream. Yeah, I remember Sid Bream in the World Series when he played with the Braves. He had that, looked like he had a wooden leg or something around in third. There's an effort right there. So, and that looks really good too. I don't remember who said it. I don't think it was Milo, but Milo quoted it that someone said Nepper's, he's a three-speed pitcher. Slow, slower, and slowest. Knepper was far from a power pitcher, but a very effective pitcher, and actually had a lot of strikeouts for a guy who did not throw with no velocity this year. strikeouts, 130, 100, you know, any guy had, you know, 100 strikeouts plus every season. But go back and YouTube some of his stuff. Man, just curveball, changeup, super curveball, super slow changeup. But the guy could hit spots and remain calm, and kind of cool to watch, man. Cool to watch. He ended up growing a pretty big mustache, too. There's the Cobra. I'm a little bit off there. So, anyway, guys, kind of see how I'm looking at here. But, yeah, this was 86 tops, man. I'm going to be really delicate with these two because these look really sharp. Oh, why are these over here? I don't know. But there's the Boggs. So same, that one is off left to right and top to bottom. Third year, Nunez. He's a really bad one, top to bottom. Yeah, that's almost cut off. It was off in cards that were just totally cut off. They're 11s. Not the greatest complexion in the world. That one looks pretty good, but it's got a little wrinkle right at the top. I don't know if the light's picking up, but that card's pretty solid centering wise. Bottom bullet. So I ended up going to the Astros. But he was in that rotation, too, and came out of the bullpen later. Good pitcher. All right, how do you get that nickname, the bottom bullet? Anybody knows, help me out with that one. So, like I said, baseball, I don't know. Much more stories in baseball because I guess the way the game is, you've got the announcers, so you're always hearing them play and they're always commenting, right, because they have this odd time where football, it's, you know, it's literally play-by-play, drops back, you know, blah, 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 where in baseball, you're in between pitches, so there's all this dead air time that the guys got to talk. And luckily, the Astros had, and still have, I think, a great, great set of announcers. But going back to Milo Hamilton and Bill Brown, and it was Milo and Larry Durker. And come on, pick up here. There you go. Just outstanding stories. Outstanding. And they were obviously, you know, lifelong baseball guys. So I picked up, I learned a lot of baseball just from listening to those guys talk. George Vukovic. So if you guys have a favorite player from this era or favorite card in this set, let me know. I'm just curious, right? I like to read the comments. I know that it may go a day or two, but I always reply to all the comments anybody puts, so don't worry about getting ignored or shut out, guys. I Roddy McDowell. I like it, right? I appreciate the interaction. Tommy Herr, I appreciate the support of the channel, obviously, and the support of Big League. We've had a great start to this year, so it's much very appreciated. Paul Householder, anybody big hair there too, huh? Householder, I don't remember him at all. UB Rooks, there's an example, you know, right to the top there, cut off. Another big mustache. There's Rigetti. That was not too bad. Up high, just a little bit on the top. Let's see, what is that? What was his record this year? Let's see. 12-7. 11-10. I think he went above. I'm sorry, Bob Lilson was still the manager in 85, which is obviously when the 86 set came out. And Hal Lanier became the manager in 86. And then, obviously, that's the year they won the National League West on Mike Scott's no-hitter. That card looks good, though, too, for a manager card. A little off top to bottom. Tom Bernanke, Bruno, as they used to call him up there. That one's got a little bit of a soft corner. I said these cards, fat guys, as you can see, it's not a lot to it. You could crush a corner. You can crush one right now just by dropping it. These were not made for durability, that's for sure. Nice guy. There's Rossi Staub. This is his last year card. Look at that. Look at that. First year is 1963. 62. Well, no, 63? So 62 was the first year of the Colts, but he came over the next year. And then obviously he played for the Astros, too, for a couple years early on. Was that his first? Yeah. And, you know, too bad the guy couldn't remain an Astro for his entire life. Because he had a really, really solid career. I'm looking at the stats there. Just number of years for 2015, 20 plus homers all the time. Rusty Staub. Kittle, look at that. That's a little scary there. Moniker. There's a Hawk. He played with Montreal. Man, it's quite amazing how many players started with Montreal, but obviously didn't finish there. Yeah, that market just didn't, I don't think it just supported financially, so anytime a player got good, he was gone, like, the next year. It just couldn't, didn't have that backing there. Ticket sales and everything to, I'm assuming, keep players around of any quality. Calvin Davis. Mighty Herzog. Solid baseball guy. Buckner, and it gets by Buckner. Look at those eyebrows, man. Holy cow. I don't know if I could take that. Looks like he's got a couple mustaches on his head there. Al Trevino, he ended up playing catcher. One of the Astros announcers, too, for the Spanish channel here in Houston. Been that way for a long time, so. Bert B. Holm Blylevin. That was the best nickname, I think, old Chris Berman ever came up with. Bert B. Holm Blylevin. Once got a Jerry Don Gleaton. Craig Nettles. It's off just a little bit. The back looks good. There you go. There's a little Happy Hooten. Long-time Astros pitching coach. Ah, a little spot right there. It's in there. Lou Randolph. A little heavy on the top. Not much. Mickey Telden, big catcher. There's a very, very well-rounded player right there in Kevin Bass for the Astros. And he also did a heck of a Sammy Davis Jr. impression. So if you get a chance, you can find that on YouTube also. Leon Durham. Big first baseman, remember him for the Cubs. Dusty Roscoe. Yeah. I just remember 86, man, the Astros. Should have just... Oh, man, anyway. Should have won that game a couple different times on some strikeouts that didn't get called. So, sure. And like I said, the Astros win that game 6. Scotty's pitching game 7. Astros going to the World Series, no doubt about it. Mike Scott was not touchable that year, and he was crushing everybody in that series. It was unbelievable. Bobby Cox with the Blue Jays. Montana was a good player. Ron Mathis. I don't remember him at all. Ron Mathis? It's kind of, he had a set with 792 cards, so there's a lot of guys that made a card that, you said you may not, they were like maybe a one-and-done guy or didn't play much at all. So, kind of wild. Let's see here. Maybe over. So, we got, like I said, we're going to have to sample a few of these here. Definitely want to get them out. Just look at that color, guys. Just the shine on these cards. No service for it. There's a Rod Carew. A little bit of a, showing it right there. I can see it. There's a little bit of a line there, a little surface scratch. These throwback the clocks were pretty cool. I wonder what, I have to look back and see how these, in terms of secondary market, go for high grade. A little Smitty, solid closer, long time for the Astros. There he goes, King Kong. Abe Kingman. Sparky, the guy always looked old, man. I always looked old. Clancy ended up going to the Astros, too. He didn't do much. And Dennis Martinez. Solid pitcher. Larry McWilliams, look at that delivery. That's interesting. Like he's in the Hokey Pokey or something. That's kind of, that's interesting. Ken Herbeck. Mark Bailey, he's our backup catcher. I think it was a stack right there, Mazzilli. Bruno, yeah. And so I think I'll probably, I'll definitely do this more often. One, I'm enjoying the heck out of it. Hopefully you guys are too. It's maybe a little bit long. We're already at 20 minutes already, but I don't know. If you don't like it, you can always shut her down and go to the next one. But this is pretty cool stuff. Jack Clark. Hey, the guy probably took the hardest swing I've ever seen in a baseball. Really no necessary smoothness or rhythm to it. Semi-off balance, just pack. Obviously, when he hit it, it would go a long way. But, man, he was just swinging that thing like he wanted to kill somebody. It was a Chuck Tanner. This card's almost perfect, guys. Too bad it's a Chuck Tanner manager card. but like I said, we'll put it up there. There's a Harry Spillman, kind of a all-around player for the Astros. Lee Smith, this guy could bring it to you. How big was this guy, Lee Smith? 6'6", 235. Yeah, I just remember him being a massive dude on the mound there. Hatcher. Damn, Pichard. I remember that guy. I'm trying to think. I don't think there's any errors in this year. There probably is, but nothing is coming to mind. Vince Coleman stole a lot of bases. Francona. Phil Dolly. I'm going to do the next special. Hey, Joe Carter. Like a little bit of Jerry Curl, too. Not a whole lot. Chris Brown. Steve Trout. He's a Cooper. He's a fielder. And you're going back. Look at Cecil Fielder. It's actually a little bit svelte right there. He played for Toronto. Much better food in Detroit, I'm assuming. There you go, the big bopper. And this is a dude that get it a long way. Really solid fielder, too, for a guy his size. How big was Glenn? 6'3", 218. 210? Nah, he wasn't 210. He was about 230. 230, he was a big dude. Tom Seaver. Julio Franco. Guy played until he was like 107. Scott Gurrell. Second name always cracked me up. Gurrell. I don't know why. And Bouchelle, I thought this guy was always just a meatball. I don't know why. Yeah, Scott Gurrell. What is about that name? Gurrell. I don't know. It sounds weird. All right. As you guys can tell, I'm having a good time with this stuff. And I can talk. And, you know, it's funny. I'm not actually a big talker, but obviously the cards bring back tons of memories, right? It's pretty crazy. Kurt Wardle. God, look at that color, guys. Mike Gallego. Good player. Small dude. Yeah, he's got some, like, ink overflow on it. Mookie. I'm thinking this may be one of the sets that I put together where I took out maybe a bunch of Astro star players. Maybe not. I mean, there was a Smitty in there, the Kevin Bass, Bob Forrest, then Ken Forrest. Yeah, the ink would run on these. Yeah, oh. Very typical, right? They pull them off too early and just the ink would go all over the place. Kenzie Colby. So every pitcher, I don't think you can find a card where this guy does not have these sunglasses on. I don't know if he had some bad eyes or... or maybe just always light sensitive and he always had the sunglasses on, but he always had those on. Pat Garrillo. No heavy on top. There's a Kirby Puckett. Gosh. A little bit off left to right. And top to bottom, too. Got a little swirl right there. Sutcliffe. Alan Ashby. Underrated catcher. I mean, he wasn't much at the plate, but the guy could call a game. I don't know how many hitters he caught. Quite a bit. He got what? He caught Nolan's, obviously. He caught Scotty's. Did he catch two Nolans? No, because the fifth was in Houston, and the other two, the last two were in Texas. So yeah, but really solid. Oberfield Sky was reminding me of, like, a mountain man. There's Don Sutton. Orangeville. There's Cal Ripken. My second card. I don't remember that card much. Caritas. Guess I need to pull that Cal out. I don't know if she had a shot at an 8. Definitely an 8. I don't know about a 9. What do you guys think about that Cal? Like I'm speaking, we did have I think two out of four 86 tops traded come back at a 10 that we submitted. I mean, it's pretty off left to right. It's definitely eight, maybe top to bottom too. I mean, it could be a 9 depending on how you put it, but I mean the color's good, corners look really good. I don't know, we'll put it up here. Hang on to her. That's what counts third year. Still a youngster there. This is probably a long video, guys. Shoot, we're at 26 minutes, so it's probably gonna be close to 45 minutes. So if you're digging it, cool. If not, I apologize. it's gonna take a lot of time on the channel. I think that's Nazi Gian rookie, I think, isn't it? Yeah, it is. That one's off though, left to right. Tony Armas. The census. Tony Pena. Take a long time. Bobby Valentine, long time header for the Rangers. Aaron Dalton. I'm pretty small. He ended up being a really big dude. This Dalton's right here. Yeah. There's Malter. That's right. They got a big old thing right there. Gosh, the bummer. There you go. There's Scotty. Off a tattoo, but now that looks good. There's Jack Morris. A little bit off top to bottom there. Another Hall of Famer. Tim Tolman. Man, I don't remember him at all. Charlie Huff. The knuckleball in there. Sixto Lizcano. There's a Rock Reigns card. And that one's really good top to bottom. Really good. Just a tad off left to right. Doggone. But you can see what I'm talking about with this set, guys. Just, man, so much to worry about. But he'll end up playing some of the last year of the Astros. Same as I said back then, right, it was, you know, you had three sets, right? Well, you had three sets. You had Donruss, Fleer, and Topps. And there was no update there. Chrome, right? This was it. And packs were 35 cents, I think, of this stuff, 86 originally. The Gibson there, little fish eye there in the eye. But it was still fun, man. It was really fun back then. I think it was more fun back then. God, it's George Soft. Really bad top to bottom, so bummer. Great Ghost could, you know, go in and buy some packs. And I remember I thought I was big time when I bought. The first box I bought was a 87, and I remember, you're like, you just started thinking, you're like, why would I buy a box of 86 tops or packs? I just thought the set looked cool, right? And you could still get them in card shops. And like I said, there was no hobby or retail, right? It was just, I guess technically it was all hobby because they didn't sell them. Well, they sold them in stores too. They were hard to get. You almost had to go to a card shop to get packs. But then who was it? Sears or somebody, you could actually order boxes online. And I think that's how I got it. It was Kmart or one of the big retailers, not online, but through the catalog. They were online back then, obviously. But that's back when you had catalogs, and you go into the kitchen there under your mom's cabinet, look at the catalog, and be like, oh, cool, you can order baseball cards through here. I think that's how I got my first box. And then I'll just say Cesar Cedeno for a long time, the Astros. Heck of a hitter there. I think that's how I got the first, like, full box before I actually bought a box and ended up playing for the Astros, too. out of a card shop. Now look at that one. Tony Fernandez. Lefferts. Johnny Grubb. Isn't that good? Badly off center left right. This guy looks like a bad impression of Chuck Norris or something. You can move a little quicker now. So 85. Who in the World Series 85? Was it the Cardinals? Is the Tigers 84? I think Cardinals 85, Mets 86, 87. Oh, there was 87. The Oakland? No. That was before they started getting good again. 87. I mean, who won the World Series in 87? I'm drawing a complete blank. Minnesota, the Twins. That's when Viola had a heck of a year in 88. Yeah. 88, I'm out on that one. I can't remember at all. Greg Gagne. Balboni. I think he's on. The car looks really good. He took a baseball to the eye there. Jacked his career up. Bad. That was sad, too. Gary Carter. That's off just a little bit, not much. Bob Rogers. Jerry Reed. Not the snowman, but... this Jerry Reed. You guys got that one? Two sacks. Really showing my age, huh? Saying all this stuff. There you go. It's down to baseball. Ah, look at those corners, man. Both of those corners are touched. What a bummer. Not off too bad, but he's off a little bit. Al Nipper. That's actually one of the cards I was hoping to. Larry Anderson. So, this is the guy, just so you know, who we traded get Jeff Bagwell for. So he went from the Phillies to the Astros, and then he was traded to Boston for Jeff Bagwell. Maybe the best trade in, I can say, ever, but pretty dang close when you compare to what you got. Don't get me wrong, Larry was a good pitcher, but you know, a reliever, you know, probably, you know, better half of the league to a future Hall of Famer. There's Cheo right there, Bella. Look at that hair. Like Backman, never liked the way he looked either. Nick and Concepcion. Hey, you guys feel about that way? Just some people, you don't like their face, you know what I mean? There's Schmidt. Top to bottom. Left right looks good, though. Record Breakers. Oh, man, I forgot about these. I think. No, I guess not. I thought Nolan may have had a card in there. I'm getting through it, guys. It'd be cool to buy a vending box of stuff right now. And just want to see how it is. That's the only problem now, right? They still have sealed boxes, but stuff's getting moved around and shipped. And just inside the packs, and the packs are inside the box. Just, oof. It can be rough there. Steve Carlton with some short hair. Maybe Lopes. Paid a decent amount of games for the Astros. As Mookie with some pretty wicked looking shades on there. There's Alan Trammell. He's got a little surface issue right there. And picking it up. Razor Shines. That's the name right there, baby. Razor Shines. Is it Joe Negro? pitched a long time for the Astros, from 75 to 85. 75 to 80, yeah. 10 years for the Astros. Horsizer. Oh, look at that. A little bit of bad painting there in the O and the D. That looks really good, though. Chet Lemon. Chet. That's a really bad name. It's got to be short for Chester or something, though, right? Chet. Well, I don't know if Chester's any better, but sorry, no offense to anybody with the name Chester. No offense. Sorry, I had to throw that one in there. I hadn't done that in a while. This has fun on a Thursday night, you know. Lee's Aguayo. The Winfield off center. Sean Dunston, that's a rookie year. No. The Straw. Top to bottom. And left to right. Phil Garner. Player and future Astros. Manager? Yeah, what happened there? The light got all blue, that's weird. Jay Templeton. There you go, Eddie. Joe Orsolak. There you are. Rafael Ramirez has been playing shortstop for the Astros a little while. He always had an interesting look on his face. That's Craig, the man who taught, I came out of nowhere, Mike Scott, the split finger fastball. Alright, I think we can get this last stack out in one big swoop here. No, my hands aren't that big. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I thought it was another Ozzie Guillen. So, wait a minute. I did some doubles here. But I think, I think there are some cards pulled that I may have either off or put in a binder. I pulled a lot of Astros and had them in a binder. Only because, Frank DePino. So, I haven't come across the Nolan yet. Eric Davis. Man, I'm terribly off center. Tommy Phillips. That's an interesting card. What? There's Eddie Murray. Off a little bit. I think Griffey Sr. Man, I'm hungry again. This is Lance McCullers' dad. Obviously, this is Lance McCullers Sr. A little bit of resemblance with the eyes, but that kind of different shaped. I'm going to say different personalities, but Lance is kind of a free-spirited guy. But anyway, that's his old man right there. Billy Hatcher, he ended up going to the Astros after that. Made a great play in game one, I think, of that 86 NLCS. Manny Dykstra, he had a big old chaw. I don't know if he ended up having any complications with that. Obviously, we know the late, great Tony Gwynn died of that mouth cancer, and just terrible. Billy Doran, heck of a first baseman. Long time player for the Astros. It's terrible. Terrible. Yeah, I must pull some cards out of here. Like you can see, there's a bunch of Hall of Famers that I'm not seeing. Uh-oh. I think my puppy just fell. Hang on, guys. I'll be right back. Alright, guys. Sorry, he's okay. I said puppy, but he's my 15 and a half year old mixed breed. I have to put him up in the bed when he's ready to sleep, and I guess he wasn't quite ready. And I built a set of stairs for him, but he thinks a little tricky, so he kind of went off the side there, and I think maybe gave him a little scare. But he's good. He's over there smiling at me, so I'll get him a breath of fresh air here in a minute. And those are the cards we already went through. He's okay though. You hear them in the background, little yelp there. So these are kind of some throwback cards. And yeah, I think I did take. Actually, I'm sure of it now because obviously the Nolan's not in here. Oh, there's the Gwen. They're just talking about. That's not too bad. Left to right a little bit. Uribe. There's the Pete Rose. That was not too bad either. And these are, I don't know, these were, I think these are okay. They were kind of cool looking, but Rose had this set. I think he's kind of like the first player to ever have like an insert set that had all of his cards in it. Which I remember being interesting when I first came across it. But anyway, guys, that's it. Let me know what you think. Like I said, I know it was very long, so 45 minutes just on the dot there. But I wanted to share that. Like I said, it I think this is worth sharing. We look at the condition of these cards, guys. I mean, look at the color and the shine on these. Impressive. But like I said, these have been sitting in a box for 30-something years. Like I said, I think I've looked at this particular set twice. I do have another set that I put together. Maybe we'll do that one in a couple months, but I think we'll look at another set next Thursday. Or we may just break some old retro stuff. I think we're going to break some 16 football that we got in the back there. But that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I did. But have a good night. Respect the hobby, and we'll talk to you guys later. Thanks.